Madras High Court has given a go-ahead for the erection of banners from Chennai Airport to Mahabalipuram on behalf of the centre and Tamil Nadu government to welcome Chinese President Xi Jinping. Now, the court has said that permission is not required since the ban is applicable only to political parties. The court has also stressed on the point that the public should not be inconvenienced at all. Pramod, of course, we know we're just weeks after Shubhashree, in fact, lost her life because of an illegal banner. And this is one issue that has been plaguing the entire state of Tamil Nadu for a long time now. But here, permission seems to have been given by the court.
Here, what has occurred is that the central and state government had gone ahead and they placed a kind of an agenda in front of the court, Madras High Court, stating that they would like to raise banners in 41 locations, and the Madras High Court very clearly want to find out whether this comes under the law or not. Madras High Court then, after like investigating the matter, it said that like there is no blanket ban on placing banners except for illegal banners. What the government have to do is that they have to make sure that they are not causing any kind of intrusion to the public. At the same time, all rules and regulations are followed. In fact, earlier in 2018, a set of rule has been created to make sure that the banners don't turn out illegal. For instance, if the road is just 10 feet like in width, for that a certain amount of size banner can only you can place it. If the road is above 10 feet, you can increase the banner size. But at the same time, each banner should carry a notice on it claiming that the so-and-so authority has given permission to it. And you cannot place a banner on the footpath blocking it. And you can definitely not place a banner on the middle of the road. However, the Tamil Nadu government and the representative for external affairs came forward and said that they have chosen 41 locations to place the banners. Mostly they will use personal structure, strong structures, and also that they will never in any way cause inconvenience to the public. So keeping that in mind, the Madras High Court has directed them, insisted that the number one concern should be given to make sure that no inconvenience is caused to any public.
Right, Pramod. So at this point in time, just to understand, this means that if anybody wants to, any party or anybody wants to put up a banner, they need to approach the court and take special permission. Is that right?
Well, already this thing was placed over there. In fact, like last year when AIDMK conducted this MGR centenary program, they did place banners. And in fact, we highlighted that though the banners permission was given to a maximum of 20, there were almost 200 banners in one area itself. We also highlighted how certain banners there was like posters or notice on it and how there were not notice anywhere. In fact, they completely covered the footpath. The problem here is that, yes, you have permission to place the banners. You need to get the permission from the authorities, the corporation, the traffic authorities and everything. But in the state of Tamil Nadu, continuously we've seen how it's being abused. And that's why people are not ready to accept banner culture in any way. In fact, all this while there were no banners and people were extremely happy that at least now the state government was for adhering to the rules. But once again, the state government and the center has gone ahead and said that to welcome the Chinese premier and the Indian prime minister, they would like to place the banners. We just want to wait and watch how it's going to turn out, whether the banner culture will once again be abused.
All right, Pramod, thanks for getting us all those details. We'll of course have to wait and watch. Remember, this has been a big issue as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned. Thanks for getting us those details on both the stories.